check this shit out.
Hello? These guys are paying me $13,000 to post videos of me playing imposter.
What?
Sick, right? Dude, it's hilarious. Either you're a crew member and you're trying to enjoy your little bean life, or you're an imposter and you're trying to run around and kill all the little bean people before they can figure out you're not who you're saying you are. Dude, it is rad.
We have Jake Alexander Williams with us. Look at that guy on screen.
Yeah, he's pretty handsome.
Yeah, he is pretty handsome. His name's Tom, right?
Yes.
Can you tell me a little bit about your character, Tom, and the actor?
Absolutely. He was such a blast to play. He was this ball of energy, and I loved getting to come to set and just have this ability to just be silly. Because so many roles that I've played haven't given me the opportunity to go as far as I did with Tom. And so I will always be forever grateful for the role of Tom, because he was so much fun.
Bro, what are you doing? Are you crazy?
Bro, let's just give it to the cops, all right? They'll know what to do with it.
No way! They'll just take whatever's in here and sell it or something. I mean, it's not gonna bring 212 back to life. The only people that know about it are you and me. This is yours. It is in your possession. The right thing for you to do would be for you to keep it.
So tell me a little bit about your favorite experience on set.
I loved meeting all the people. Everyone that I met on the set was so great to work with. And I honestly think it was one of my favorite experiences on set that I've had the ability to do so far. And so I'm just so thankful getting to meet all these cool people.
So this movie boasts a large and wonderful cast of characters and people. Is there any performance or any scene that sticks out to you after watching the film, the actor?
Oh, absolutely. I would say, honestly, after watching the preview of the movie, the person that stood out to me most was Caroline Kelly is her name. She played the waitress. And her scene made me emotional watching it, just because, I mean, we've all been there. And it was such a great moment. And I just love that scene so much.
Your scene is what made me emotional in this film. I cried when I found out, you know, your scene. I don't want to give too much away. So you have some very violent and physical scenes in this. Can you
yes.
walk me through what you thought when you read that on the script?
I was actually talking to my girlfriend about this earlier. It's so different reading the scene and then doing the scene. So it's like I read over the scene and was like, yeah, this is easy. I got this. Then I got the set and it's like your nerves really kick in, especially because my hands were physically tied down. And so that adds a whole other element of like, wow, I'm a little on edge because like, you know, you're trying to stay in the moment. But also like you've got these great other actors that are in your face and they were truly scary in that scene. They're fantastic actors.
Yeah. So you were actually tied up?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Whoa. Yeah, and my hands were actually zip-tied down to the chair. And so you really, I mean, like, just trying to move around, I mean, it adds a whole nother level to the scene.
No, you don't need to do this, guys. This is crazy.
Now, as you can see, Tom, we're looking for something. Did you or Hunter happen to find anything next door? Like, anyone give you guys anything to hold on to?
I don't know what you're talking about, man. This is bullshit!
What was it like working with director Richard Blake, who you even had some scenes with?
He was such a good actor to work with, and I always love the opportunity to work with directors that are also actors because they just understand like a whole nother level of what it's like mm-hmm. to be acting, so they're able to connect on another level. And going back to that violent scene, one of the things I really appreciate working with him was during that scene, he kept checking on me to make sure I was good. He's like, do you need water? Do you need me to like untie you so you can get up? It was really sweet, and no, he's phenomenal, and I'm very excited for people to see him play this role because he's great.
That's good. It's nice to have that kind of safety.
Oh, yeah. No,
on a
I mean,
set,
it gives
I'm
you,
sure.
And it gives you freedom, too, to be able yeah. to do what you want and like try new things because, I mean, with knowing that someone was there watching out for me, it just gives you a whole nother level to be like, okay, I can go a little bit further into this.
Atlanta based rock band Collective Soul is the soundtrack for the movie The Actor.
Mm hmm.
And I heard from a little bird that you may live in Atlanta as well.
I do.
Are you a fan of Collective Soul's albums?
I am, yeah. I got more into their music after I read this script because I saw it mentioned a couple times. And so while I was reading the script, I started listening to their music, and now I listen to it all the time. My favorite song that they have is Welcome All Again. And I listen to that while I write my own scripts. So I'll have it playing in my ear just because it gives me kind of the vibe of things that I look for. And yeah, so I'm really excited that they're part of this project. And yeah, it's been awesome.
Awesome. And so you're a writer as well?
I am, yes. I do a lot of writing and I'm also a director too.
Cool. Are you able to tell us anything about what you're working on or any future projects that you're in that we can look out for you for?
Yes. So I've been working on a audio drama for the past couple months with some great people. We just finished principal recording last night, actually, at 11:30 p.m. And so I flew here this morning. But another project that I'm really excited about is I just got my first opportunity to go direct my first feature film next year out in New Mexico. And so I'll be out there for about a month, and I'm writing that script as well. They hired me to write it and direct it.
Can you tell us a little bit about that project that you're directing?
I can. So it's a war movie, and it's about World War III that starts in 1995. So we're kind of rewriting history a little bit, and it focuses more on the soldiers and their internal relationships inside of the base and all the refugees that live around them. So it's a really cool script, and I'm really excited for people to see it as well.
Sounds really fresh and unique too. Very, very cool. Well, thank you so much for joining us today. Such a pleasure.
Yeah, thank you for having me.